This is MLB Now, presented by Fisher Investments. Our guest is Bob Klapisch, New York Times baseball writer. He and Paul Solitara are the authors of the book Inside the Empire, The True Power of the New York Yankees. It's available now wherever books are sold. Bob, let's talk about the big picture here in baseball in this city. The Yankees, obviously, they're World Series contenders, maybe the contender going into 2020. The Mets have a new manager in Carlos Beltran. But as you look back on the previous decade, the Mets made it to a World Series. The Yankees didn't win a World Series for the first time as far as decades are concerned. So where is baseball in the state, in the city of New York, when you consider these two franchises?
Well, if we're talking about today, right now, I think Yankee fans have every reason to believe that they have finally reached the promised land, as we've been talking about on the show. Gerrit Cole makes them the preeminent franchise in the American League, probably the entire industry. Met fans, not quite so much. They're sort of in a no man's land. They're not rebuilding. They're not the best team in this division by far. Look, I mean, the world champs are sitting right there on top of them in the NL East. It's a tough division. You got the Braves, who are excellent. The Phillies are all in. The Mets have their work cut out for them just to get to October. I mean, I don't think that they're a bad team. I think they're capable of winning 85, 86, 87 games. But I don't even know if that's going to get them to the wild card.
So when you look back at the decade that was, the Mets getting to the World Series, coming up just a bit short, and as mentioned, a lack of a World Series title for the New York Yankees, what stands out to you of the previous decade for these two teams?
That World Series for the Mets just came out of nowhere. It was a fun time in New York, and I do believe that from way back in the day, New York is a National League town. When the Mets are good, when the Mets are great, it just doesn't happen that often. Yeah. The Yankees had an unusual decade. They did not have a losing season. They are a model of efficiency. They make a ton of money. They're consistently leaders in attendance in the American League. Everything about them is successful, except that they don't have a championship to show for it. Remember, this is a franchise that says, if we don't win the World Series, it's a failure. That has been the motto from the George Steinbrenner era. Suddenly, that narrative has changed. Now they're trying to sell to their fans that we are a great team. We win 103 games last year, and we're good enough to get to the postseason where anything can happen. That doesn't fly indefinitely in New York, and I think that impatience, that restlessness among the fans, in large part drove the signing of Gerrit Cole.
For fans that don't live in the tri-state area or in the city, can you explain the rivalry or how these two teams compete without actually always playing each other on the field?
Well, it goes back to all the way back to the 50s, the Yankees and the Dodgers and meeting each other in the World Series. There's something about New York baseball, of course, with the New York Giants as well. I mean, the real rivals are the Yankees and the Red Sox. I mean, that's who they face 19 times a year when the two teams were good. But it's sort of like a brotherly thing. Who's better? Even though they don't play each other, who's better? It's more of a friendly rivalry. That has really no bearing on the standings. It's just, neighbors getting together and bashing their heads.
And lastly, I mentioned the book, Inside the Empire, The True Power of the Yankees. What is the power of the Yankees? I mean, obviously success is a component there, but what else?
Well, this team was able to rebuild itself in 2016 on the fly. Yeah. Unlike the Astros or the Red Sox, the Yankees never had to finish last. They have consistently been a winning club to get to where they are now. All they needed was that final piece. But this team is really, really well run. There's no question they are a model of success.
Yeah. We mentioned the book is out now. It's a great gift idea. And there's going to be a new chapter when it comes out in paperback in April of 2020, correct?
Correct. It will cover the 2019 season. So you can buy it on Amazon right now.
All right. We'll be looking for that. That's Bob Klapisch.